Hey there, geographers, and welcome back to the Mr. Sinn channel. Last time we talked about topic 2.5. We looked at the demographic transition model and the epidemiological transition model. Today we're focusing on unit 2, topic 6. We're looking at Malthusian theory. The world's population today continues to grow and grow. And the big question on everyone's mind is, well, when is it going to stop? Or is it going to stop? Take a couple of seconds and think to yourself, is the world becoming overpopulated? And if so, should governments step in to stop this from happening? If you answered yes, you actually might be a believer of Thomas Malthus. He was an English economist who looked at population, and he was alive during the Industrial Revolution. So we know from our last video he was alive in stage 2 of that demographic transition model. And what he noticed was that population continued to grow at an exponential rate, but our food production was only growing arithmetically, meaning that we were going to run into this Malthusian crisis, where our population would exceed our carrying capacity, where we would start to run into famine and war and disease, and all this stuff would destroy the very fabric of society. So Malthus believed that we actually needed to control population, that governments needed to step in, and if governments didn't take control, then we would start to see the environment actually take action against humanity. Today we still study Thomas Malthus because he was one of the first people to really look at demographic data and to understand what was happening with population growth and our food supply. Malthus published his thoughts in an essay on the principles of population. In it he says that the power of population is so superior to the power of the earth to produce subsistence for man, that premature death must in some shape or other visit the human race. What he's referencing here is a Malthusian catastrophe. We can see that we only can produce so much food, and when our population exceeds our carrying capacity, we're going to run into some issues. So we understand Malthus's idea and his theory, but also maybe some of you are thinking, well, hold on a minute. We're still here today. Malthus, the Industrial Revolution, that was a long time ago. And you're right. Malthus did not know about stage 3, 4, or even 5 of that demographic transition model. He also didn't anticipate how much more productivity we would gain from increase in technology or our agricultural revolutions, which allowed us to get larger yields from our crops. And so he wasn't able to anticipate that our food actually wouldn't grow arithmetically and that eventually our population would slow down. And instead of a J curve chart, we would actually start to see more of a logistic growth, where we can see that as countries develop, eventually our growth levels off. Again, because of that stage 3 and 4, where our NIR now is decreasing due to advancements in technology, urbanization, and empowerment of women. And even at the time, there were still people critical of Malthus. A lot of people didn't think his message was very pro-family, and they criticized him for being anti-large families, which at the time was very popular. Again, connecting back to stage 2 of that demographic transition model, we know that the CBR stays high, even though the deaths are starting to shrink. There's going to be our growth then for society. And they also thought he was a little bit of an alarmist. So unfortunately for Malthus, he's criticized today and also in the past. So we've addressed some of the criticism of Malthus, but there are actually some parts of his theory that do work today. We are seeing some countries with this exponential growth still, as they are still struggling to get out of stage 2 of that demographic transition model. And we also have some countries that limit contraceptives, that limit family planning, and still are viewing women as childbearers. So their population growth rate continues to excel, and that doubling time is still relatively short. Today, we still have people that believe in Thomas Malthus and his ideas. However, they accept that it's not just food. They actually look at Thomas Malthus and said, he was close, but he wasn't exactly right. He limited the scope too much. Neo-Malthusians today are people who believe in Thomas Malthus, but they say it's not just food we're going to run out of, it's resources in general. The world has a finite supply of natural resources, and as our population continues to grow, we are running out of them. We only have so many non-renewable resources, and even our renewable ones are being used at a rate that the earth can't replenish. We are consuming things too quickly. All of this again is going to lead to a new catastrophe where eventually the world just can't support our population. And maybe this sounds a little familiar to you.
Little one, it's a simple calculus. This universe is finite, its resources finite. If life is left unchecked, life will cease to exist. It needs correction.
You don't know that!
I'm the only one who knows that.
That's right, Thanos would actually be a Neo-Malthusian. He doesn't believe in the original idea of Malthus, but the underlying concepts he does. He believes that the world's resources are limited, and if we continue to grow, we're going to run into this catastrophe. And so his solution is to kill off half the world's population, which actually, if we study demography and we look at populations, we know actually wouldn't work. All that would happen is eventually we'd have another population boom, and you just have to keep repeating. Whereas if we just let societies develop and move further in that demographic transition model, their growth rates will just automatically come down. At the end of the day, we still have a lot of people who would consider themselves Neo-Malthusians. They would look at climate change, desertification, and what's happening to the world to try and show that, hey, it's because of our overpopulation and we need to regulate and we need to control it. Otherwise, we're going to be going into a catastrophe. So what do you think? Is Neo-Malthusians right? Is Malthus right? Let me know in the comments below. Also, don't forget to answer the different quiz questions that are on the screen right now. And of course, consider subscribing. It helps support the channel and allows me to make more videos. All right, thank you so much for watching, geographers. That's all we have for today's video. Until next time, I'm Mr. Sinn, and I'll see you online.